Egypt had one of the largest and most complex pantheons of gods of any civilization in the ancient world. Over the course of Egyptian history, hundreds of gods and goddesses were worshipped. The characteristic of individual gods could be hard to pin down. Most had a principal association, for example, with the sun or the underworld, and form, of course. But this could change over time as gods rose and fell in importance and evolved in ways that corresponded to development in Egyptian society. Here is a few of the most important details to know. Osiris, one of Egypt's most important deities, was god of the underworld. He also symbolized death, resurrection and the circle of nine worlds that Egypt relied on for agricultural fertility. According to the myth, Osiris was the king of Egypt who was murdered and dismembered by his brother Seth. His wife Isis reassembled his body and resurrected him, allowing them to convey his son, the god Horus. He was the representative of a mummified king, wearing wrappings that left only the green skin of his hands and face exposed. The origins of Isis are obscure. Unlike many gods, she can be tied to a specific town, and there are no certain mentions of her in the earliest Egyptian literature. Over time, she grew in importance, but eventually becoming the most important goddess in the pantheon. As devoted wife who resurrected Osiris after his murder and raised their son Horus, Isis embodied the traditional Egyptian virtues of wife and mother. As the wife of the god of the underworld, Isis was also one of the main deities concerned with rites for the dead. Along with her sister Anubis, Isis acted as divine mourner, and her maternal care was often depicted as extending to the dead in the underworld. Isis was one of the last of the ancient Egyptian gods to still be worshipped. In Greco-Roman period, she was identified with the Greek goddess Aphrodite, and her cult spread as far west as Great Britain and as far east as Afghanistan. It's believed that depictions of Isis with the infant Horus infected Christian imagery of Mary with the infant Jesus. Depicted as a falcon or as a manly falcon's head, Horus was a sky god associated with war and hunting. He was also the embodiment of divine kingship, and in some eras the king was considered to be a manifestation of Horus. According to the Osiris myth, Horus was the son of Isis and Osiris, magically convicted after the murder of Osiris by his brother Seth. Horus was raised to avenge his father's murder. One tradition holds that Horus lost his left eye fighting with Seth, but his eye was magically healed by the god Thoth. Because the right and left eyes of Horus were associated, respectively, with the sun and the moon, the loss and reconstruction of Horus' left eye gave a mystical explanation for the phases of the moon. Seth was the god of chaos, violence, desert and storms. In the Osiris myth, he is the murderer of Osiris. Seth's appearance poses a problem for Egyptologists. He is often depicted as animal or as an human with the head of animal, but they can't figure out what animal he's supposed to be. He usually has a long snout and long ears that are squared at the tips. In his fully animal form, he has a thin dog-like body and a straight tail with a tuft on the end. One of several deities associated with the sun, the god Ra was usually represented with a human body and the head of a hawk. It was believed that he sailed across the sky in a boat each day and made a passage through the underworld each night, during which he would have to defeat the snake god Apophis in order to rise again. Anubis was concerned with funeral practices and the care of the dead. He was usually represented as a jackal or as a man with the head of a jackal. The association of jackals with death and funerals likely arose because Egyptians would have observed jackals scavenging around centimeters. According to the Osiris myth, Anubis embalmed and wrapped the body of the murdered king, becoming the patron god for embalmers. Thoth, the god of writing and medicine, could be depicted in form of a baboon or a sacred ibis, or as a man with the head of an ibis. He was believed to have invented the language and the hieroglyphic script, and to serve as a scribe and advisor for the gods. As the god of wisdom, Thoth was said to possess knowledge of magic and secrets unavailable to the other gods. In underworld sense, showing the judgment undergone by the descendants after their death, Thoth is depicted as weighted the hearts of the descendants.